Hi there. Welcome to the Axure RP repeater series. Over the next several videos, you'll learn how to use the repeater widget to create dynamic, data-driven prototypes in Axure RP. In this video, we'll go over the basics of the repeater widget. You'll learn how to add widgets to a repeater, how to add data to the repeater's dataset, and how to display data on widgets in the repeater. Let's start off by looking at the structure of the repeater. The repeater widget is a sort of container that duplicates, or repeats, its contained widgets a certain number of times. The widgets that get repeated are collectively called the item. You can edit the widgets in the item by double-clicking the repeater. Each repetition of the item can be different from the others, and the differences are controlled by the repeater's dataset. The dataset is a spreadsheet-like table of data that's located in the style pane. The item is repeated once for each row in the dataset, and widgets in the item can be linked to the dataset's columns to display the data. For example, the rectangle widget in the default repeater is linked to column 0 in the repeater's dataset. If we add a new row, we get another rectangle, and the rectangle displays the value we entered in the new column 0 cell. Widgets in repeaters will only change if you intentionally link them to the dataset. This item dataset linking is handled by the repeater's item loaded interaction. If we look at the default repeater, we see a set text action that sets the rectangle's text to item.column0 in a bracketed expression. You can use this notation, item.columName, to link a widget to any column in the dataset. Let's give that a try. Add a new column to the dataset and name it MyColumn. Then, enter some data in the column cells. Next, double-click the repeater to edit its item and drag a label widget onto the canvas. Now go to the Interactions pane. Hover over the Set Text action and click Add Target to the right. Select the label widget in the dropdown that appears. In the Value field, enter item.myColumn enclosed in double square brackets, and then click OK. The data from your new dataset column should be displayed on the label widget. It's worth noting here that not all widgets in the item have to be linked to the dataset. If you want a widget to appear and behave the same way in every repetition of the item, just edit it on the canvas as you would any other widget. That's it for now. In the coming videos, we'll look at how to store and use other types of data in repeater widgets, such as images and links, as well as how to manipulate text before it's displayed. Thanks for watching, and happy prototyping!